Welcome back, dear students. Today, we are going to study the part 6 of decision control structures in Java. Students, in this part, we are going to study the do while loop in the looping control structures. So let us quickly begin with the do while loop in Java. Now students, what is do while loop? Just like while loop, the do while loop also consists of block of code and condition. So in the previous part you studied that in while loop also there is a condition. Okay, so there is a condition with the while statement. Okay, and then there is a block of statement. So this curly braces, inside this curly braces, this is the block of the block of statements. Okay, that is going to be executed. And this is the increment decrement. In any looping control structure, there are three things that are essential. The condition associated with the loop, okay, the block of statements, and the increment decrement operator. And one more thing is essential, that is the initialization expression. Okay, in the same manner, in the do while loop also, okay, it consists of block of code and condition. Now, the while loop checks the condition first and then executes the statement. Okay, you have seen in while loop, see, this is the condition, this is the statements block. Okay, this is the block inside which the statement is written, and first there is condition, but this is while loop, students. In the while loop, you have the condition first. First, the condition will be checked, and if this condition is true, only then this part will be executed. If the condition is false, then it will come out of the loop. The execution or the flow of control will come out of the loop and the program might terminate. Okay. Now, the while loop checks the condition first. This is the while loop, and then executes the statements. On the other hand, right now we are studying about the do while loop. Okay, so do while loop first executes the block of statements. Okay, first it will execute the block of statement once, and after executing the block of statement one, then it will check for the condition. Okay, if the condition is true, the code within the block is repeated. Okay, otherwise the loop is terminated and the control moves to the statement that appears after while loop. Okay, so what is difference between the while loop and do while loop? The difference between while loop and do while loop is that in while loop, it first checks for the condition. Okay, see, this is while loop. So it is first checking the condition, and then if the condition is true, then this block of statement gets executed, and then increment happens, and after increment again the condition is checked. Okay, this is while loop. But what is in the case of do while loop? Do while loop is different than while loop. How? Because in do while loop, the do while loop first executes the block of statement for once. That means first time, even if the condition is not true, it doesn't matter. Okay, the condition is true or false, it doesn't matter. For the first time, the statements are going to get executed, and then after the statements get executed, then it will check for the condition. Okay, so let us quickly see the syntax of the do while loop. Okay, now let me quickly erase this. Yes, since the do while loop checks the condition after executing the block of statements. Okay, so after executing the block of statement once, okay, for the first time it will execute the block of statement, and then it will check for the condition. Okay, so do while loop is considered as an exit controlled loop. Okay, the do while loop is called as exit control loop. Why it is called for called as exit control loop? Because do while loop checks the condition after executing the block of statements for the first time. So for the first time, the statements will be executed and then the condition will be checked. Okay, so this is the syntax of the do while loop. Okay, now initialization expression, which is essential. Okay, first the initialization expression, then do keyword is used. After the do keyword, you have the block of statements, and after the block of statements gets executed for the first time, then we have this while keyword, and along with this while, you have your condition. So what will happen? First, it will start from this initialization expression. Then whatever statements are there inside this block of statements will get executed. Okay, it doesn't matter if this condition is true or false. For the first time, this statements are going to be executed, and after the statement gets executed for the first time, then this condition is checked. Okay, so since the do while loop checks the condition after executing the block of statements, so the do while loop is considered as an exit controlled loop. The program gets executed at least once. If you are using do while loop, the program will be executed at least once, even if the condition is evaluated to false. So let me show you a quick example related to this. So now I am opening my BlueJ, and this is a very basic program for the do while loop. Okay, so look at this program. Public class do while loop. So this is my class name. Okay, I have opened the class with this curly brace. Okay, and then this is my main method, public static void main string of args. Then I have opened the main method. Now inside the main method, we have started with initialization. Every loop has a initialization. See, this is the initialization expression. Okay, int I equal to 1. I have taken a variable I, okay, whose initial value or the starting value is 1, and this is of the integer data type. Okay, now this is the do keyword. See, over here also there is do keyword after the initialization expression. Now inside the block of statements after the do, I have written system.out.println welcome to Java. So I have written something. Now what will this statement, this line do? It will print this welcome to Java on the terminal or the output screen. Okay, now after this, this is the increment decrement operator. As you know, every looping control structure has an increment or decrement expression. So this is the increment expression i++. What is this going to do? As soon as the control of the program comes to this part, it will increase the value of I every time by 1. Okay, so if the value of I is 1, then as soon as the flow of control comes over here, it will become the I value of new value of I will become 2. And then again the condition will be checked. And in this form, this loop will continue until this condition becomes false. As soon as this condition becomes false, the flow of control will come out of the loop. Okay, so let me show you the output of this program. So I'll compile this program and I'll run this program, and as you can see, this program is printing this welcome to Java statement 10 times. Why it is printing this statement 10 times? Because see, my condition is I is less than or equal to 10. So, and the initial value of I is 1. So what is happening is the initial value of I is 1. Okay, then it comes to this statement and it does what? System.out.println welcome to Java. So this statement is printed for the first time, and then it comes over here and the value of I becomes 2, and then it checks for the condition, is 2 less than or equal to 10? The condition is true, so the loop is again executed. And then again this statement gets executed. Now the value of I becomes 3. Okay, and then again this condition is checked. In the same manner, again and again the same thing is repeated and the same statement gets printed. But till when? till the value of I is less than or equal to 10. When the value of this I becomes 11, the loop gets terminated and the program stops execution. So that is why it only prints this statement how many times? 10 times. Okay. So again, let me show you the output. So this is the output. Now students, now we studied one thing. What did we study? That the do while loop, in the do while loop, the program gets executed at least once, even if the condition is evaluated to false. So students, suppose if I make the condition false, I can make this condition false by increasing the value of I greater than 10. So suppose I give the initial value of I as 13. So what will happen? What will happen is that it will initialize the first value of I is now 13, and now it will come to the do loop. Okay. For the first time, the statement will get executed because it doesn't matter what the value of I is. Okay. And for the once, the statement will be printed. Then from 13, the value will become 14. Okay. And now it will check this condition that is associated with while. And now, is 14 less than or equal to 10? This is false. And because this is false, the program will come out of this loop and it will stop the execution. Okay. Now, even though this condition is false, the statement got executed once. Let me show you the output. So, see, the statement got executed once. Why? Because this is do while loop. Okay. So I hope you understood the meaning of this statement. The program gets executed at least once, even if the condition is evaluated to false. Okay. Now let us study another quick example on this do while loop. Write a program to print next 10 alphabets starting from the letter G. And the output should be displayed in a vertical order. So this is a very easy program. They have created a public a class alphabets. Okay. Then they have opened this class. Public static void main string args. This is our main method. Now inside the main method, initialization expression. They have taken a variable I, which is of integer data type, and its initial value is 1. The variable I is declared and initialized. Okay, what is the initial value of I? 1. And then they have taken one more variable, which is of character data type, char A, and its initial value is G, because they have told write a program to print the next 10 alphabets starting after the letter G. So what will be your initial value of this? It will be G, because we have to start from the letter G and we have to print the next 10 alphabets. Now that the initialization is complete, okay, now we come to the do. We write the do statement or the do keyword and then we write the block of statements. So system.out.println print A, print the value of A. The initial value of A is G. See, G. Now, what is this? You have studied in chapter 5 that whatever the character data type, the value of character data type is always enclosed in single quotes. Okay. So system.out.println print A. What is the first value of A? The first value of A is G. Okay. So for the first time it will print G. So see, the starting output is G. Start the first line of output is G. Okay. Then we have to use the increment decrement operator on both these variables because both the variables have been initialized over here. So I plus plus will increase the value of this by 1. So this 1 will become 2 after executing this. Okay. This will become 2 and A plus plus, the value of A plus plus. A plus plus means what? From G, it will go to the next one. Okay. H. Okay. Now it has become H. Okay. I has become 2. This has become H. and now it will come to this while and it will check for I is less than or equal to 10. The value of I is 2. So this is true. So it will go back to this. Okay, it will go back over here and come and print this. Now the value of A has increased from G to H. So it will print H. Okay, now it will come to I, and now the I's value will be 3. Okay, now the I's value, the value of I will from 2, it will increase to 3. Okay, and the value of A plus plus will become from H to I. Okay, capital I. Now, again, it will check for this condition. Is 3 less than or equal to 10? The condition is true. And because the condition is true, it will come back and execute this statement. And now I will be printed. In the same manner, everything will be printed till P. And now when this will become P, when the value of this will become P, that time the value of this will be 10. Okay. Now what will happen is that it will, the value of this will become 11. After printing P, the value will be 11. And when this, it will come to over here to, the value of I will be 10 only. Sorry. And then after coming over here, if 10 is less than or equal to 10 is true. Now it will come over here, check for the condition, and then this time the condition will be false when it takes the value to 11. Okay. Now when the value becomes 11, this condition will be false and the statement will be terminated. So you will get a stable or you will get an output from G, H, I, J to P. These are the next 10 alphabets. Now let us take a look at the next program on do while loop. The next program is write a program to find the factorial of 5. Factorial of 5. Now what is factorial of 5? Students, you will be studying later on in the mathematics the concept of factorial. Now what is factorial, students? Factorial, suppose if we take 5 factorial, it is written like this, 5 and this exclamation mark. Now factorial can be written in one more way like this, okay? But we are not writing factorial like this in our computer. In our computer, we represent 5 factorial like this, okay? Now, what is the mathematical symbol, importance of this factorial, 5 factorial, okay? 5 factorial means 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Okay. In the same manner, if somebody asks you what is 10 factorial, 10 factorial means what? 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 dot 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 into 1. Okay, so 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. This is the value of 10 factorial. So in the same manner, you can find factorials of different numbers using this particular technique. Okay, so what we need to do, we have to write a program in Java to find the factorial of 5. Okay. Now you know what is 5 factorial of 5. Okay. Now how to do this? You start with the writing the class name. Suppose you have given the class name as factorial. Then you open the class. Then this is the main method. You open the main method. Now you start with the initialization. Okay. So you have to initialize two things over here. Now first you have taken a variable I. Okay, and you have initialized its value as 5. Why 5? Because you have to find the factorial of 5. That's why. Okay, and then you take another variable f. Okay, and you initialize its value to 1. Okay, you initialize its value to 1. Now, what is f over here? F means factorial. Okay, f means what? Factorial. But over here, what we are going to do, again and again we are going to use this f to multiply with the value of 5, and then we are going to decrement the value of 5. So the first value will be, what will happen, the first value of f will be, it will start from 1, but after that, what does f equals to f into 1 over here, this statement symbolize? This statement means what? The next value of f after the value of 1 will be, whatever is the value of f, suppose the first value of f is 1, and then what is value of I? 5. So we will start with 5 into 1. So we got this 5. Okay, then after this, the value of this I is what? 5. So it will decrement from 5 to 4. So next it will come from what? Come to what? 4 into 1. In the next iteration, what will happen? The value will decrease, because this is the decrement operator. Okay, so it will become what? 3. So it will become 3 into 1. Then 2 into 1. And then 1 into 1. And then after 1 into 1, if it decrements further, so it will become 0. Is 0 greater than or equal to 1? So this condition will become false. And after this condition becomes false, we'll just print whatever is the latest value of f. The latest value of f will be this. Okay. And then we'll print the value of f, and then we will come out of our program. Okay. So this is the explanation of this program. Okay. Now, students, let us see this program in BlueJ. So see, I have typed the same program. We have initialized the two variables I and f, and then what have we written? We have written do. Do what? F equals to f into I. F into I. The first value of f and I is 5 and 1. So what? F, the value of this f is what? 5 into 1. Okay. And then you decrement the value of I by 1, because this is I minus minus. I minus minus means decrement the value of I by 1. Okay. So if it is 5, you decrement it by 1. So it will become 4. Now this condition will be checked. The condition is true. If the condition is true, it will go back to the loop. Okay. And inside the loop, again it will come. It will check 4 into 1, because the value had become 4 after this decrement. Now, after the value was 4, okay, the value of I was 4, okay, so afterwards it comes to what? This I minus minus. So from 4 it will become 3, and so on till the value becomes 1. Okay, the value becomes 1, again it will go to the loop, and then I minus minus will make it 0. As soon as this value of I becomes 0, the condition will become false and the loop will be terminated, and then the final value of f will be printed. Okay, so let us compile this program, close this program, and then run this program, and you will see the factorial of 5 is 120. Okay, if you want to change the value, you just go over here and change the value of I to, suppose you want to find the factorial of 7. So just make the initial value of I as 7, you compile the program, close it, and then the factorial of 7 is 50. Or why it is coming 5 over here? Because you have to change over here also in the print statement. Now compile it, close it, and now see the factorial of 7 is 5040, and this is how you find the factorial. You write the program for calculating the factorial using the do while loop. So I hope we have studied the program for finding the factorial of number using the do while loop. Okay, so this was the do while loop, which is also known as the exit control loop. Okay, students. So with this, I come to the end of this chapter. If you have any doubts related to this chapter, please don't hesitate to ask me in the comment section. Okay. Thank you for listening. Take care of yourself and be well.